In premature ovarian failure, which is also called primary ovarian insufficiency, the ovaries stop functioning normally. And this means that they stop ovulating or releasing egg cells. And they also stop producing hormones, mainly estrogen and progesterone. And this all happens before a woman is 40 years old. It's considered a primary problem because the problem is with the ovaries themselves, rather than the glands or the hormones that act on the ovaries. Normally, the hypothalamus, which is located at the base of the brain, secretes gonadotropin-releasing hormone, or GnRH. GnRH makes the nearby pituitary gland secrete two hormones of its own, called gonadotropins. These are follicle-stimulating hormone, or FSH, and luteinizing hormone, or LH. These hormones travel to the follicles within the ovaries. The follicles are small clusters of granulosa and theca cells that protect the developing egg. FSH acts on the granulosa cells, making the follicles grow and mature as well as secrete estrogen, while LH stimulates the theca cells to secrete progesterone and small amounts of androstenedione, which is a precursor to testosterone. All three of these hormones belong to the class of steroids, or lipid-soluble hormones. At birth, a woman has millions of follicles, each ready and excited to do its job. During puberty, the monthly menstrual and ovarian cycles begin, which is when the endometrium, or inner lining of the uterus, goes through cyclic changes in response to the ovarian hormones. During the ovarian cycle, the ovarian hormones also help a handful of follicles to start growing. Eventually, there's ovulation, which is when a single follicle fully matures and ruptures, releasing its egg cell, while the other follicles degenerate and die off. Over time, many ovarian follicles degenerate, and the ones that remain become less and less sensitive to gonadotropin stimulation. This goes on until menopause, when there are no remaining follicles responding to gonadotropins, and that causes menstruation and ovulation to cease entirely. In most women, this occurs between the age of 40 and 60. Now, in premature ovarian failure, the follicles stop responding to gonadotropin stimulation earlier than usual, that being before the age of 40. In the majority of cases, there's no clear cause. In some cases, it's linked to chromosomal abnormalities, like Turner syndrome, where an X chromosome is missing. Other times it can be gene mutations, like BRCA1, or in a syndrome, like Fragile X syndrome, which is caused by the expansion of a trinucleotide repeat within a gene on the X chromosome. In other cases, the ovaries can get harmed by chemo or radiotherapy, or by an autoimmune destruction process where the immune system goes rogue and attacks the ovaries. There are two proposed mechanisms that could explain how premature ovarian failure develops. The first mechanism is that there are few or no remaining follicles in the ovary, and this could be because the ovary started out with only a few, or because a lot of them degenerated too quickly. The second mechanism is that the follicles are dysfunctional, meaning that they're present but simply can't do their normal job, either because they can't generate gonadotropins themselves, or because they don't respond to the gonadotropins, or because they can't generate hormones themselves. In any case, the ovaries fail to respond to pituitary LH and FSH, which means that they don't release egg cells normally and produce less estrogen, progesterone, and androstenedione. However, about half of these women maintain some intermittent ovarian function. In premature ovarian failure, when estrogen levels are low, the pituitary gland attempts to restore balance by increasing production of gonadotropins, LH and FSH. However, the follicles don't respond, so there are still low levels of estrogen. This is called hypergonadotropic, because the level of gonadotropins is high, hypogonadism, because the level of gonadal or ovarian hormones is low. Some symptoms of premature ovarian failure are directly related to the absence of ovulation and the low levels of estrogen and progesterone. Most women have a normal puberty with regular periods before the disorder develops, but then start having troubles when premature ovarian failure occurs. Absence of ovulation causes missed or infrequent menstrual periods. and it also causes difficulty conceiving or infertility. The lack of hormones can cause hot flashes, night sweats, and vaginal dryness, which can lead to dyspareunia or pain during sex. Estrogen normally has a protective effect on the cardiovascular system, helping to keep the blood vessel walls flexible to accommodate blood flow, as well as the skeleton, where it helps to sustain bone density. So, low levels of estrogen can also lead to complications like cardiovascular disease and osteoporosis, or decreased bone density. In general, the symptoms mimic natural menopause, but unlike menopause, some women are still able to spontaneously get pregnant because they have intermittent ovarian function. Diagnosis of premature ovarian failure can be done by detecting low levels of ovarian hormones, mainly estrogen, and increased levels of LH and FSH. Additionally, a karyotype can be done to look for chromosomal abnormalities, and specific genetic tests can be ordered if there's a family history of Fragile X syndrome. If autoimmune causes are suspected, testing for steroid cell antibodies, or STCAs, which react to adrenal cortex cells can be done. That's because there's a similarity between ovarian cells and the cells of the adrenal cortex. The main goal of treatment is to replace the hormones that the ovaries have stopped producing, especially estrogen and progesterone. For women who struggle with infertility, in vitro fertilization can be used. Eggs are taken from a donor, fertilized, and then implanted into the hormonally prepared uterus of a woman with premature ovarian failure. All right, so as a quick recap, premature ovarian failure occurs before age 40 and is caused by not having enough follicles in the ovaries or having follicles that don't respond to gonadotropins. The result is that the ovaries fail to respond to pituitary LH and FSH, which means that they don't ovulate or release egg cells normally, and they produce less estrogen, progesterone, and androstenedione. This can lead to symptoms that mimic menopause, but some women with intermittent ovarian function are still able to get spontaneously pregnant. Hi everyone, Sarah here. Thank you for watching. That was my second ever video, premature ovarian failure. So I'd love to hear what you've got to say about it. So if you can pop some feedback in the comments, that would be great. That script was written by Antonia and edited by Rishi. And I did the illustration, the voiceover, and the editing. Thank you again for watching. And if you like that video and other videos that are on the Osmosis YouTube channel, make sure you head over to osmosis.org where there are tons more videos and a lot of them aren't actually released on YouTube. There's also questions and flashcards and a whole bunch of resources which are super useful for medical school. Also check out our Facebook page, our Twitter and our Instagram and anything you can find just to give us a bit of feedback because we love that. And I look forward to making the next video for you. Thanks, bye!